How Higgs boson gave mass to the universe. The early universe was very hot and dense. All the matter we see today was created at the very first moment of time, almost 13 billion years ago. In the early universe, for one moment, every particle was massless. Then suddenly, they weren't massless anymore. All because of Higgs boson. But how did this happen? How was Higgs boson able to give mass to the universe? If we extrapolate back in time as far as possible, we'd come to a time before the first galaxies formed, before the first stars ignited, before neutral atoms or atomic nuclei or even stable matter could exist. The earliest moment at which we can describe our universe as hot, dense, and uniformly full of stuff is known as the Big Bang. The early universe was filled with all the particles, antiparticles, and radiation it had the energy to create. As the universe expanded, it cooled down, stretching the fabric of space and in turn also stretching the wavelength of all radiations to longer wavelengths. The universe was entirely empty during inflation. There were no particles, substances, or photons, only empty space. That empty space contains a tremendous quantity of energy, the exact amount of which varies slightly over time. Those variations are stretched to bigger scales, while new, small-scale oscillations emerge on top. The particles came after some time in the equation. If there are any particles and antiparticles at greater energies that were yet to be discovered, they were most likely generated in the hot Big Bang, as long as there was enough energy, E, available to create a massive M particle using Einstein's E equals mc squared. It's possible that new physics at these early times will solve a slew of mysteries about our universe, such as the origin of matter-antimatter asymmetry and the formation of dark matter. However, the huge particles we are familiar with today are alien to us. They have no mass in these early phases. The particles and antiparticles of the standard model are easy to create, even as the universe cools down over a small period of time. The universe may have begun with energies as high as 10 to the power of 15 or 10 to the power of 16 GeV, which gradually decreased over time. We can today construct the whole suite of particle-antiparticle pairs known to physics at the energies attained by the LHC. But in the early universe, at this point, they were all massless. They had no choice but to move at the speed of light if they had no rest mass. What is the cause of particles being in this unusual, bizarre form that is so different from how they are now? This is due to the fact that the basic symmetry that gives rise to the Higgs boson, the electroweak symmetry, has not yet broken in the universe. When we look at the standard model today, it's arranged as follows. The electroweak symmetry, however, is violated at today's low energy scale. In the early days of the universe, this symmetry was restored, and when it is restored as opposed to shattered, the standard model view is profoundly altered. Instead of the weak and electromagnetic bosons, W+, W-, Z0, gamma, the first three of which are quite large and the fourth of which is massless, we have four new bosons for the electroweak force: W1, W2, W3, B, all of which have no mass at all. The other particles are identical, except that they, too, do not yet have mass. This is what's going on in the early universe, colliding, annihilating, and spontaneously forming all at the speed of light. All of this continues as the universe expands and cools. As long as the energy of our universe is above a specific threshold, you can't imagine the Higgs field hovering atop the liquid in a soda or wine bottle. As the liquid level falls, the Higgs field remains atop the liquid and everything remains massless. This is referred to as a restored symmetry condition. However, below a certain liquid level, the container's bottom begins to reveal itself, and the field can no longer remain in the center. More broadly, it can no longer take on any old worth. It must travel where the liquid level is, which is down into the divots at the bottom of the bottle. This is referred to as a broken symmetry state. When the symmetry is broken, the Higgs field enters the bottom, lowest energy equilibrium state. That energy state, however, is not quite zero. It has a limited non-zero value known as the vacuum expectation value. Whereas the restored symmetry state produced just massless particles, the broken symmetry state causes a complete transformation. When the symmetry is broken, the Higgs field has four mass-containing consequences, two of which are charged, one positive and one negative, and two of which are neutral. And the following events occur all at once. This is the origin of mass in the universe. This entire process is known as spontaneous symmetry breakdown. When the Higgs symmetry for quarks and leptons in the Standard Model is broken, every particle gains mass due to two factors, the expected value of the Higgs field and a coupling constant. And this is where the issue arises. The Higgs field explanation value is the same for all of these particles and is not difficult to calculate. But what about that coupling constant? It is not only distinct for each particle, but it is also arbitrary in the Standard Model. We know the particles have mass, we know how they gain mass, and we found the particles that cause mass. But we still don't know why the particles have the masses that they have. We don't know why the coupling constants have the couplings they have. The Higgs boson, the gauge bosons, and the quark leptons are all real. We have exceptional abilities to produce, identify, and quantify their qualities. However, knowing why they have the values that they do is a problem that we have yet to solve. We don't know the solution. Everything known to exist in the universe today is massless and moves at the speed of light prior to the shattering of the electroweak symmetry. When the Higgs symmetry breaks, mass is added to the universe's quarks and leptons, as well as the W and Z bosons, and the Higgs boson itself. With such large mass differences between light and heavy particles, the heavy ones spontaneously decay into the lighter ones on very short time frames, especially when the universe's energy, E, fall below the mass equivalent, M, required to form these unstable particles via E equals mc². Existence would be impossible without this essential gauge symmetry linked with electroweak symmetry breaking, because there are no stable bound states formed entirely of massless particles. But now that fundamental masses have been assigned to quarks and charged leptons, the universe can do something it has never done before. It has the ability to cool and form bound states such as protons and neutrons. It can cool even more, forming atomic nuclei and finally neutral atoms. And given enough time, it can give birth to stars, galaxies, planets, and humans. None of this would be conceivable without the Higgs boson, which provides mass to the universe. Despite the fact that it took 50 years to discover, the Higgs boson has been making the universe possible for 13.8 billion years. To have such a phenomenon in our early universe was amazing. We all owe our existence to the Higgs boson, or sometimes also known as the God particle. So what do you think about the importance and role of Higgs boson in our universe? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks.